We're digging into Indian food. You're watching A Mouthful.
Brought to you by Bristol's Wines and Spirits and Premier Crew. BTC, every day.
Sharwood's Cooking Sauce. Cook like a real chef and serve up some excitement. Ask for it at your favorite grocery stores. Welcome back, foodies. You're watching A Mouthful with Dre, or should I say Namaste. Today, we're headed to one of the best kept secrets on Parliament Street, Taj Mahal, where we're gonna dig into authentic Indian food. We introduced you to Indian food at Cultural Fest, but today we're gonna get all those other types of dishes, the sargosh, the naan, and maybe some curries. Food fact for you, curries is not a spice. It's actually a combination of spices. So anything that has a lot of spices in it is considered curries. And those types of things is what I want to teach you today, what I want to give you in this adventure in taste. So let's go see what Manjan has for us. Manager of Taj Mahal, and she is beautifully dressed.
Namaste.
So Manjit, how long has Taj Mahal been around? This is truly a beautiful restaurant. So tell me, what's your hours? How long have you been around?
We have been here going on 9 years now. Yeah, our hours are 12 to 3, 5:30 to 11, with the exception of lunch on a Sunday. But we're here still 6 to 11 on a Sunday as well.
Okay. Tell me about your food. What is your favorite dish? What is the top seller?
Top seller. I would say the sargosh, spinach and lamb mix. Very tasty. Not the prettiest dish when it comes to curry. There's not very much you can do with a curry when we talk about aesthetically. Okay. But I have to say, when you taste the sargosh, which is a spinach and lamb mix with all the Indian spices, you'll be back. It's a definite must come back.
And is that the one you're serving me today?
That's one of the ones I'm serving you today.
Yay, excited! I know that you were a nurse before managing Taj Mahal, and before you were telling me all the health benefits. So tell our foodies, what's the health benefits in Indian food?
Definitely the spices. Okay. The spices, the turmeric. I mean, we have been known from the kings and the moguls' time, known for our spices. It's definitely spicing. The yeah. spices, and we fly in everything. Everything is brought in. Mm-hmm. Everything is authentic. Mm-hmm. So we're definitely doing the authentic Indian.
Nice.
The healthy way.
The healthy way. And that is what we're looking for. Great food, great tasting food with health benefits. Taj Mahal has it all. We just spoke to Manjit, and now we're gonna go into the kitchen and see what the chef has prepared for us. So now we're gonna set up a curry. And like I told you, curry is not a spice, it's a combination of spices. And the chef is gonna show you how authentic Indian curry is made. So this is definitely a treat.
So there we go with the garlic. We're using fresh spinach that we boiled down and sauteed. So we're gonna add that in, and then we're gonna then saute in the fresh lamb.
Okay.
Now this particular spinach dish, we do this with spinach and prawn. We do it with spinach and chicken. We've got it with spinach and homemade cheese or spinach and potato.
So we have three pre-made sauces that gives you all the different spices in the dishes that you're trying. Indian, authentic Indian. So we have this sauce, it's kind of chunky. You see some onions and all this great stuff in there. It's for stir fries. And then the korma dish, what the chef made for us. And then this red sauce, I'm sure we're all used to that one, right? We all order chicken masala. But today, we're gonna try authentic Indian. And we're gonna elevate your palate with different types of Indian dishes.
Guess what, guys? We finally have an amazing website for you where we'll be posting more food adventures, behind the scenes photos and blogs, and this time, even our own ratings. Go on, check us out at adventureintaste.com.
Or the kitchen, and we saw some great dishes being prepared. So now we're gonna go into the dining room and taste them. Let's go.
So here we have saag gosh, which is a spinach and lamb mix. We have here aloo gobi, aloo being potato, gobi being cauliflower, so it's a potato and cauliflower mix. Here we have a saffron rice. And here we have my favorite. It's a Long Island mutton curry. So that's where we fuse our Bahamian wow. and Indian together.
Okay.
And over here, we have some lamb korma.
Mm-hmm.
Lamb korma being the curry with the hint of coconut.
Okay.
So that's an awesome dish. So you must try that with the peshwari naan.
Good.
And outcoming, we have one of our sizzling platters and the pandan tikka. And you guys will be loose.
I'm gonna roll out of this door. I like so much food. This is truly a feast. I don't know where to start. I have so many different types of Indian dishes in front of me, and none of them are chicken masala. So, yeah, we're just gonna dig in. And this is the naan, the bullet. That you can only get at Taj Mahal. It's filled with cheese and jalapenos and sweet pepper and onion. It's nice and soft and it's not too thick. It's like Indian pizza. Cheese, jalapenos, sweet pepper, all in one good bite. This is a meal within itself, I just let you know that. And then we're gonna get the saag gosh. Manjit told me that saag is spinach and the gosh I think is the lamb, so that's a little language lesson for you. Garlic, turmeric, the green coriander, the salt, the black pepper all meshed into this wonderful dish. He steamed the spinach down, sauteed it, and then put the lamb in. So it should be really good. The lamb should be really tender. Lamb is a very different type of meat. A lot of people don't really like it, but this dish is everything. And that's her horn. I think a sizzling dish is coming. Look at that. That is amazing. Just so you know, this chicken is sitting on a bed of nice herbs and vegetables, and that makes a different sauce from the actual chicken, and all of that kind of like marries together to give you a really good, moist, juicy chicken that's beautiful to look at and tasty to eat. It's like fall off the bone. It's so good. Amazing. I know that's like my go-to word, but this really is amazing. There's citrus, there's so many different spices. The yogurt really gives the chicken a different taste. All of these dishes just gives you an adventure in taste. You go here for curries and then another place for a citrus moist chicken, and then the homemade yogurt that it's marinated in, the naan, and then the cheese just brings it all home for me. Everything was really good, and it wasn't chicken masala. It wasn't the yellow curries that we're used to. So come to Taj Mahal for authentic Indian food.
And now it's time for the Bristol Wine and Spirits and Premier Cru Wine of the Week. So Rusty, today we're diving into Indian food. Lots of spices, lamb, chicken. Can you give me a wine that I can pair with spicy foods?
I found one that's very good with Indian food, and it's a Pinot Noir. This particular Pinot Noir is from Southeast Australia. It's the Lindeman Bin 99 Pinot Noir. And the reason why it's so good with spicy food is that Pinot Noir has very gentle tannins. Tannins are that harsh thing that you find in red wines. So I'd give it a try, okay? So let us try now.
Okay. It is quite light.
It is light, and you don't have the tanning structure. It's very gentle on the palate. So, you know, do away with the sweet wines with spicy food. Let's try a Pinot Noir, and I think it'll be the perfect choice.
And where can we find it?
Bristol Wines and Spirits. In most of our branches, we have it.
Thank you, Rusty.
Because I'm such a foodie, I'm always eating great food, and I want to share them with you. So follow me on Instagram and Facebook for all the dishes that don't make it on the show. Follow me, I follow back. I am so full. I had a feast today at Taj Mahal. We had homemade cheese, we had mutton curries, we had sargosh, we had tandoori chicken. All great dishes, different flavors, different bites that you should come and try. And let's not forget that homemade ice cream that was different from any other ice cream that I've ever tasted. The chef told you how to make real naan and clay ovens and to mix real spices, authentic spices, coriander, cumin, and turmeric in pots and pans just to make a great dish. Even though I ate so much today, let's not forget all the health benefits that come with Indian food. The turmeric, the cumin, the juices that we had that had little bits of sugar but great taste. Cancer fighters, lowering blood pressure. It was great, healthy food. So be sure to visit Taj Mahal. You just had a mouthful with Dre. See you next time.
Promotional consideration brought to you by thebahamasweekly.com. BahamasLocal.com, BahamianOrNuttin.com.